Everyone's worst nightmare comes true when they try to start their car in the morning before heading to work. You find yourself with a dead battery, but why did it happen and was it avoidable? We examine 8 factors, some of which may surprise you, that can deplete the battery in your car. We also examine easy methods to identify and stop the drain. It's the Car Problems YouTube channel. Subscribe and let's get started. Human error. Everybody has been there. After a long day, you pull into the driveway and enter without turning off your headlights. It's also possible that you didn't fully shut a door or the trunk. Your car battery drains while these lights are on all night with nothing to replenish it. The car won't start in the morning for this reason. Modern cars can be equipped with alert systems that notify you when a door is open or the lights are on. However, if you don't have one of these, it's crucial to watch out for these typical mistakes. Parasitic drain. When you turn off the car but something inside keeps running, it's known as a parasitic drain. Some parts, like the memory for the clock or radio presets, are constantly powered by batteries. However, the parasitic drain may be higher than usual in the event of an electrical issue. Faulty wiring or fuses are the cause of these drains. The following is a list of typical reasons why a car battery may drain due to parasitic drain. Door light switch issue. Door lock actuator malfunctioning. Switch for trunk locking. Faulty car stereo or the wirings to it. Any electrical components installed aftermarket were done so improperly. There could be a plethora of more complex reasons behind this. One particularly frequent cause is a malfunctioning door light switch, which allows the car's lights to remain on and deplete the battery. Broken alternator. The battery has to be charged by the alternator. The car's electrical systems are also powered by it. The battery is unable to recharge when the alternator malfunctions. An alternator should typically last 7 years, or 100 to 150,000 miles. Taking short drives. The battery requires time to be charged by the alternator. You aren't letting the alternator function if all you do is drive down the street to go to the nearby grocery store. For a full charge, you should ideally take longer drives, ideally on the highway. Poor charging. Even when you are driving, the battery drains when the charging system malfunctions. The battery is refilled while traveling, once everything is functioning as it should. However, you wouldn't even be aware that the system is stopping charging if there was a worn-out tensioner or a loose belt to the alternator. Extreme temperatures. Extreme temperatures are hard on your car battery. The battery may have problems if the temperature falls below 10 degrees Fahrenheit or rises above 100 degrees. Crystals of lead sulfate start to accumulate, resulting in long-term depletion. It also becomes more challenging to fully charge the battery as a result of this accumulation. Loose or corroded battery connections. If the battery connections are loose or corroded, it may be challenging to get a full charge even if the alternator is operating properly. To make sure everything is tidy and connected, it doesn't hurt to regularly inspect the cables and terminals. Old car battery. There are instances when the battery is just too old and feeble to hold a charge. The lifespan of an automobile battery is typically 3 to 5 years. However, you may use batteries more frequently if you drive in harsh weather conditions or strain your car to its limits. How to diagnose drained car battery. What then causes your battery to discharge, and how can it be fixed? If something went wrong and you left it running, it's easy to figure out why. You can also find out if you have corroded or loose connections with a quick inspection. However, locating a parasitic drain may be considerably more challenging. To identify the offender, take these actions. Connect a multimeter. Make sure the car's electronics are all off and that the battery is ready to go. Connect your multimeter to the battery and adjust it to the maximum amp setting. There is a parasitic draw on the battery if the reading is greater than 50 milliamperes. Check the fuses. While keeping an eye on the multimeter, remove one fuse at a time. Starting at the lowest amperage and working your way up is helpful. You've located the problem if you remove a fuse that causes the reading to drop noticeably. To find out which part is giving you trouble, refer to the fuse chart found in your owner's manual. You will most likely need to conduct some additional research after this. Even if your audio system is powered by a fuse, you still need to determine whether the radio, power antenna, or any other device is consuming electricity. In this case, you will disconnect every gadget that is using that fuse until the power draw stops. That's the part that offends you. Repair the issue. It's time for a replacement once you identify the component that is depleting the battery. While some parts can be fixed without much difficulty, others might need to be fixed by a mechanic. Make sure the draw has stopped by running the multimeter test once more after replacing the faulty component. Hope the information was helpful for you. If so, please press the like button and subscribe to the channel.